The next issue that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about, He says, He discusses who is the one who is going to be steadfast on salah. And in Surah Al-An'am, Allah says, it is only those who believe in Allah and in the last day, and who believe in the Quran.
وَالَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْآخِرَةِ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِهِ وَهُمْ عَلَىٰ صَلَاتِهِمْ يُحَافِظُونَ
It is those who believe in the last day, who believe in the messenger, who believe in the Quran, who are then steadfast with their salah and they establish their salah properly. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from amongst them. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about the fact that if you have disbelievers who might have fought you, who are your enemies, they become your brothers instantly. By doing what? By declaring the shahada, establishing salah and giving zakah. So Allah says,
فَإِن تَابُوا
And this verse is in Surah At-Tawbah.
فَإِن تَابُوا وَأَقَامُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَآتَوُوا الزَّكَاةَ فَإِخْوَانُكُمْ فِي الدِّينِ
If they repent and they establish salah and they give zakah, they automatically become your brothers in deen. Instantly, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us love for all those who establish salah. And may He make us from amongst them inshallah. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about the oppression of the one who wants to stop the use of the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for something that will enhance the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah says,
وَمَنْ أَظْلَمُ مِمَّنْ مَنَعَ مَسَاجِدَ اللَّهِ أَنْ يُذْكَرَ فِيهَا اسْمُهُ وَسَعَى فِي خَرَابِهَا
Can there be anyone more oppressive than the one who is blocking Islamic activity from the masjids, from the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, activity that will enhance the remembrance of Allah, whether it is salah, whether it is a lecture, no matter what it is, whether it is a tafsir, whether it is an explanation of hadith, those who block that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is warning them, because the houses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are there to increase the spirituality of an individual, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enlightens them with Abu Jahl. What did Abu Jahl do? He was one of the enemies of Islam. And in Surah Al-Alaq, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about him.
أَرَأَيْتَ الَّذِي يَنْهَى عَبْدًا إِذَا صَلَّى
Do you see the one who is blocking the worshipper when he's trying to read salah? That was Abu Jahl. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was trying to read salah, Abu Jahl came and tried to beat him and block him and stop him. And Allah says, nay, this is the house of Allah. You can't do that. Allah will curse you if you do that. May Allah protect myself and yourselves. And this is why it is very important for those whom Allah has put in authority within the masajid to understand that they must use the masjid for Islamic activity. Proper Islamic activity that will benefit the Muslim ummah, because it will either be for them or against them on the day of Qiyamah, that you were placed in charge of the masajid by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How did you utilize that house of Allah? Did you make it your own house according to your whims and fancies, or according to the law of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Did you utilize the masjid to its full capacity? Did the people of the community benefit from that masjid in the full capacity? Or did your rules and regulations result in people running away from the masjid? If that's the case, you will be caught by the neck on the day of Qiyamah and thrown into the fire of Jahannam, because Allah says there can be no one more oppressive than such a person. Allahu Akbar. This is why it is so dangerous to be on the mosque of a, to be on the committee of a mosque. When I say dangerous, I mean it is a huge responsibility, and only those who have deep knowledge of this deen will understand the responsibility that there is when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala places on your shoulders to be on a committee that is running a masjid. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala open the doors for every single one of us. That having been said, it is a great reward as well to be on the same committee, if you are fit for it. And to be fit for it, you need to have Islamic knowledge. You need to be directly under the guidance of ulama. If you are making your own decisions, you are wrong. Even if you happen to be slightly in conformance with what Allah has said, but if you have no knowledge and you are making rulings and regulations for the house of Allah, you are wrong. May Allah protect us. It's like a plumber making decisions for a doctor. I think this example was given so many times. He will decide to put a copper pipe when there is a heart problem. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us all. And he will still think he is solving the problem. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about how to achieve assistance through salah. In Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah says, يَا
أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اسْتَعِينُوا بِالصَّبْرِ وَالصَّلَاةِ وَإِنَّهَا لَكَبِيرَةٌ إِلَّا عَلَى الْخَاشِعِينَ.
O you who believe, seek assistance in your whole life. Seek assistance for all your affairs through establishing salah and bearing patience. And definitely it is not easy to establish salah except for those who are humble and have humility for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you want assistance in your life, you need to establish salah. Let's take a look at what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says thereafter. Allah says, we need to also keep a portion of salah that we will read in our homes. Not only in the houses of Allah, but as well as the houses, we need to liven them up. Listen to what Allah says in Surah Yunus to Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. Allah says,
وَأَوْحَيْنَا إِلَى مُوسَى وَأَخِيهِ أَن تَبَوَّآ لِقَوْمِكُمَا بِمِصْرَ بُيُوتًا وَجَعَلُوا بُيُوتَكُمْ قِبْلَةً وَأَقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةِ.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is instructing Musa and his brother Harun alayhim as-salam to provide houses and dwellings for the people, for his people within Egypt, when they shifted to Egypt. And Allah says, and make your houses also places of worship. Which means keep a portion of your salah that you will read in your houses. It is the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam to read farad in the masjid and to read the sunnah and the nafil at your house. Amazing. So your children can watch that you're reading salah and they can also grow up with that, as well as the surroundings of your house can be blessed with the prayer that you are praying in the house. So to make your farad in the masjid and your sunnah and nafil at home is a sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. But what we should understand is, if out of laziness we're going to go home and forget about it, then we'd rather read it in the masjid. And I think that is the case with the bulk of us. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the ability to understand and to put into practice. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about sujood, sajda in the Quran. There are many verses in the Quran where sajda is mentioned, where prostration is mentioned. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has divided these verses into three. We are instructed to make sajda at those times. What are these times? When Allah tells us, O you who believe, make a sajda. Prostrate for my sake. We immediately fall prostrate. Then the other types of verses, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us how people in the past and how other creatures have prostrated to Allah, we declare that we are creatures and we immediately prostrate. Then Allah tells us how some people rejected to prostrate when they were commanded to prostrate out of arrogance, like Fir'aun and those people. Then we immediately prostrate in order to subtract us and to take us out of that equation of arrogance, so that we can be from amongst those who are fulfilling the law of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we abide by it. So these are known as verses of sajda. They are also included when we discuss the issue of prayer that is mentioned in the Quran. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about the sin that there is for leaving salah. The sin that there is for leaving salah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about that, as well as the fact that when someone has read their salah, immediately after salah they engage in a sin that is a far more dangerous sin. Why? Because you've just come out, you've just plugged out from communication with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you want to start lying, you want to start cheating and deceiving. Allahu Akbar. May Allah protect us. This is why, as true Muslims, if someone wants us to be completely honest, we are meant to be honest at all times, but straight after doing a good deed, we should be even more honest. May Allah protect us all and grant us understanding. Whilst we are fasting, we lie. What's the point of fasting? Immediately on opening our fast, we cheat, we steal, we commit sin. What was the point of fasting? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about this issue in Surah Al-Ma'idah regarding certain people who had to bear witness. Allah says, تَحْبِسُونَهُمَا مِن بَعْدِ الصَّلَاةِ. You must hold them back after salah. And then you ask them the questions. Then another point Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about is the reward of salah. Now, my dearest listeners, let me inform you that the reward of salah is firstly in the dunya and then in the akhirah. You want to see your life change, I promise you it will change. Just establish your salah. You read your 5 salah without being lazy. When you cross the first 40 days, you will notice your life's doors of goodness opening, subhanallah. And believe me, that's a guarantee. Some people think that, no, I've read my salah for 3 days now. I've read 5 salah a day. You were supposed to have done that your whole life. You're not going to see results in 3 days. Some tablets, you have a course of it which takes 2 months, 3 months. You can't just have 2 tablets and say, but I'm not yet better. Allahu Akbar. So the same applies with salah. If Allah wants, He can show you the benefit immediately. But what would happen is, fulfill your 5 salah, have an intention to continue doing that for the rest of your life, then see what happens. I guarantee you, every single problem of yours will be resolved because it will draw you closer to Allah. One of the points that is discussed in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, salah itself will prohibit you from evil deeds and immorality if you fulfill it properly. Listen to what Allah says in Surah Al-Ankabut.
أُتْلُ مَا أُوحِيَ إِلَيْكَ مِنَ الْكِتَابِ وَأَقِمِ الصَّلَاةِ إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ تَنْهَى عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنْكَرِ.
Read what Allah has revealed to you in terms of the book, the Quran, and establish your salah. For indeed, salah will prohibit you from immorality and evil. That is a study on its own. That is a subject on its own and a topic on its own. How salah protects a human being from evil and immorality. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us protected at all times. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about the reward of salah in the akhirah. And He says,
وَمَا تُقَدِّمُوا لِأَنفُسِكُم مِّنْ خَيْرٍ تَجِدُوهُ عِندَ اللَّهِ.
Whatever you have forwarded for the sake of yourselves, whatever you yourselves have forwarded, obviously for the sake of Allah, but for your own benefit. You have forwarded it for your own benefit. For the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will keep that reward for you and you will see it. The dunya as well as the akhirah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us steadfast. Then very beautifully, salah is actually an act of worship that will reduce our stress levels. The Quran speaks about it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says this in Surah Al-Hijr regarding the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
وَلَقَدْ نَعْلَمُ أَنَّكَ يَضِيقُ صَدْرُكَ بِمَا يَقُولُونَ فَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّكَ وَكُمْ مِنَ السَّاجِدِينَ.
O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we know that whatever they are saying, they are spreading rumors about you that you are a womanizer, you are behind money, you are after control, you are after power and so on. All those rumors that they are spreading about you, we know that they are causing your chest to be narrowed, which means, you know, you are concerned about them, it's stressing you up. So what you do, praise Allah and find yourself in the condition of prostration a lot. Be from those who prostrate. Now prostration, if you are in that position, it is the only position where the brain is lower than the heart, subhanallah. So the blood that is pumping to the brain is effortless. It will help a person whose cholesterol is high when you are in the condition of sujood. Because naturally there is no effort when the oxygenated blood is being pumped into the brain. Amazing. And this is why it is said that sujood will help relieve your stress. Just sujood itself. Even just the position of sujood, subhanallah. And we find it a burden to go and make sujood. Allahu Akbar. That position of prostration is a sacred position. It is only to be rendered for the one who created me and you. It is haram and prohibited to render that position for anyone else, any creature that Allah has created, no matter who it is. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all understanding.